Hello, I'm the Nostalgia Critic. I remember it, so you don't have to. Guess what? I was looking at the lineup, and it turns out the very next movie I'm gonna review is The Avengers! I know, can you believe it, right? One of the most hyped up comic book movies of all time! I didn't even know it was finished yet! But apparently, we're gonna take a look at it and see how it holds up. Are you ready? I know I sure am. Let's take a sneak peek at what we're in store for. A little background. The Avengers is not based on one of the best-selling comic books with some of the greatest superheroes of all time. It's instead based on a British FBI agent and his brothel of alternating hot crumpets. I guess it was sort of like a James Bond meets the Prisoner sort of thing, and before I get a million angry emails, no, I've never actually seen the show. But hey, a movie should be good despite the fact if you've seen the show at all. And depending on what I've heard about this film, we're screwed. Let's dive right into The Avengers. We start off with Secret Agent John Steve, played by Ralph Fiennes, walking through an obstacle course training him in case everybody in the friggin' world goes fucking blood hungry.
Well done, Steed.
My pleasure. Macaroons. For Mother.
And who is Mother, you may ask? Well, it turns out that Mother in this movie is a man! Well, not quite that bad. But he is the head of the Ministry of Elite Intelligence. He's played by that British guy, who always seems to be in everything, but you never bother to take the time to figure out what his name is. And if you're really ballsy enough to actually say what his real name is in the comments below, fuck you, the rest of the world knows him as that British guy whose name we can't remember. He sends out a message to another agent, Emma Peel, played by Uma Thurman, who's just moseying around the house in her everyday, ungodly expensive Chinese dress. Oh, come on, ladies, we all know you do that.
Please answer the telephone.
Good morning, Dr. Peel. We've scheduled an appointment for you. John Steed, Boodle's Gentleman's Club, 1 hour.
Did they really need to send her a package saying answer the phone? Doesn't that kind of go without saying? If the phone rings, you answer it! You really needed to waste the postage to tell her this? What other basic commands do you think she has to be told?
Answer the phone.
Answer the door.
Turn off the stove. Open the microwave.
Tell Sean Connery it's too late for this film, but he can still back out of A League of Extraordinary Gentlemen. So she enters into the Gentleman's Club, which is most unorthodox.
No women, not in Boodles, not since 1762.
Really?
She then meets up, at least since probably up now, with John Steed.
Not a woman inside Boodles since
1762.
You're not someone who plays by the rules, Doctor.
Oh, you mean like the direct rule she was given to meet up with you, even though women aren't allowed in this place? How's that breaking the rules? It's not her fault you chose a location. That makes no fucking sense.
Now that we've settled the matter of titles, will you kindly explain why you wish to meet me?
I didn't. Mother did.
Mother?
Mother.
So as they drive off to meet Mother, you may notice something very odd about the people of London in this movie. There's no people of London in this movie! What is this, 28 days later? I've never seen the place so abandoned! Maybe they heard they were filming this shithole and evacuated the city to save on therapy bills.
Tea?
Sugar, one lump.
So Peel talks about how she was working on a weather shield that was being built as a defense mechanism. The only problem is the research lab has been blown up by an all-too-familiar face.
You're our chief suspect.
I'm innocent, of course. Why would I sabotage my own project?
You tell us. You'll be allowed a privilege. Prove your innocence. If you didn't blow up Prospero, find out who did.
Really? You have video evidence that she is the culprit and you're actually gonna let her solve the case? This seems a tad backwards.
He'd like us to work as a team.
You mean I have to trust you?
Trust? It's your face that got you're caught on the video camera, you dumb broad! He should be having a hard time trusting you!
You think Mrs. Peel is dangerous, Father?
All in my report.
Wait. Father. The woman's name is Father. Let me see if I understand this ministry correctly. You have a woman named Father, a man named Mother, a package instructing agents how to pick up a phone, a message telling a woman to meet in a place where no women are allowed, and most likely letting a criminal with hard evidence against her solve her own crime? Does anything in this agency make sense? Everything is totally friggin' upside down! Hell, while we're at it, why don't we throw in some more confusing names?
Yes, after you have the information, drop it off to Agent Sister, who will then drop it off to Agent Brother, right after handing it over to Agent Cat, who will relay the message to Mr. Dog, and Mr. Dog will confirm it with Agent Black. I'm so glad things work so sensibly around here!
My theory goes, Mrs. Peel may be ill.
Revenge is a possible motive.
She certainly fits our profile.
It is not only possible, it is essential.
So they talk about what they're going to do to solve the case while sword fighting. Why? Well, see if you can guess.
Artificially creating new weather systems.
You're a lady of hidden talents, Mrs. Peel. A little more flexibility in the wrist.
If you haven't figured it out yet, this whole entire movie is based on one friggin' joke. They're polite. They perform incredibly dangerous stunts and react with a calm, friendly retort. That's it! That's where all the humor in this movie comes from!
To what do you attribute your overachievements?
My father always wanted a boy.
I failed to see the connection.
So did he.
Now, let's take out the fact that this is all based on one joke, and a particularly weak one at that, and ask one question. If nobody in this movie becomes passionate or excited about what they're doing, why should we? Why should we care if they make it out of a situation when clearly they have as much energy and drive as Victorian senior citizen porn? Do they ever become interested in anything? Nope. They just talk politely about it throughout the entire movie.
Marvelous weather, not the sort of day to be stuck in town. I think we ought to get away.
We?
Yes, just the two of us. Weekend in the country. How about it, Mrs. Peel?
Depends what you have in mind.
Well, I'm a nature lover, so whatever comes naturally.
I'd say they were just right for harvesting, wouldn't you? I would indeed. Indeed, I would.
Should we be making plans tonight?
We
Let's go
are.
Harvesting.
I thought we'd have
you.
Time to play a social visit.
You first.
I
After you.
Much.
Thank you.
Well, let's see if Sean Connery, one of the reigning kings of cool, can spice things up a bit. He plays an ex-agent named Dr. August de Winter. And the Avengers, which I just realized are never called the Avengers in this movie, nor are they ever avenging anything, have a feeling his obsession with the weather might have something to do with the case.
Ah, yes, the monsoons. Oh, even as a boy, when Nana taught me the naming of the clouds.
Cumulus.
Yes.
Stratocumulus.
Oh, yes.
Nimbus.
Oh, I discovered then nothing beats a good lashing. Mind your head.
God! Even Sean Connery and all his coolness can't save this snorefest! On top of that, he's not even that smooth. He comes across as sort of an awkward, horny old man.
I have always admired a woman who is meteorologically inclined. Touch it, Dr. Peel. Allow me. Please touch it.
Do you mind?
One should never fear being wet.
Don't worry, I have a dozen other Roger Moore pickup lines.
But Mr. Steed comes across an unusual sight, a sudden snowstorm, accompanied by Mrs. Peel in her Queen of Narnia cosplay. He then wakes up finding Mrs. Peel attending to his wounds. Does this freak him out at all? Nah!
You tried to shoot me, didn't you?
I would never shoot you. Not without my reasons.
I remember it clearly. But luckily, my Trubshaw waistcoat was bulletproof.
Boy, it'd be really cool if maybe they showed us this vest, either being tested out or explained like any other good spy flick. But hell with that ass, we got more bantering to do!
I'm the sort that doesn't take no for an answer.
I think that would depend entirely on the question, Mrs. Peel.
Nursing an invalid isn't my idea of fun after all.
Awfully disappointing weather today. The weather. Awfully disappointing today.
I did find a clue.
Yes. Yes, I know what you mean.
So they go to a secret underground company called Wonderland Weather, where they the fuck?
Welcome to Wonderland Weather, here in our London headquarters.
The fuck? When did this turn into the Grateful Dead's teddy bear picnic? I'm sorry, movie, I'm sorry, you can't do that! You can't do that! You can't have nothing but bland characters, bland dialogue, and bland visuals throughout the entire film, and then suddenly throw this shit at us?
You all know who I am, and I know all of you. But you cannot know one another.
I guess the idea is supposed to be that they're all in disguise because they're such big names, but